I'm baked! My face looks flawless. Super flawless. This man baked his whole face. Is this right? He is moving. Patrick, you are moving. Hey guys, what is up? What's going on? It's Ashley and welcome back to the channel. So for today's video, what I'm going to be doing is that viral video that has been going all around the internet. I tried following Blankety Blank's makeup tutorial. In today's video, I will be following PatrickStarrr's makeup tutorial, kind of like his warm barbecue smoky eyes, kind of like that's kind of what I decided to go with. Let me just get this out in the forefront. I ran into a lot of technical difficulties. I decided to go with Patrick because he does his makeup so much differently than I do my makeup. I don't bake, I don't do anything like that. I do my eyeshadow first, I don't do my base first. So I really wanted to do somebody that was going to challenge me to kind of do things differently. So you guys will see that in the video. If you guys like these kind of videos and you guys like me, don't forget to press that subscribe button. And also don't forget to turn on your push notifications so that way you guys are notified anytime I upload a new video, which is 2 times a week, every single week. And without further ado, guys, let's go ahead and hop into it. So before we begin, I think it's important for all of you guys to know that I went back to dark hair, and no, I'm not talking black. This is my natural hair color. I did have like a little bit of ombre towards the very ends of my hair, but I was getting sick of it. I was getting tired of it. I knew deep down I wasn't gonna go back and retouch it, so I figured I might as well just get rid of it because it wasn't very like blended after all the chops I did throughout the year. So I'm just completely dark now. It's a little weird to look at myself in the viewfinder, but you know what? We're gonna get through it. Anyways, in today's video, what I'm going to be doing is that video that has been trending all over YouTube. I tried following so-and-so's makeup tutorial. I will be following PatrickStarrr's makeup tutorial. I did go on his page and I kind of stalked it a little bit and I was like, what can I do? What video can I recreate? And I decided to go with this guy right here, which was his barbecue makeup tutorial. Okay, all right, I'll see ya. Okay, anyways, so yeah, that's the look I'm going to be recreating. I did check it out. I do have majority of the products. Some products I didn't have, so I'm just gonna kind of use what I got. You know what I mean, Jelly Bean? So we're gonna be recreating. Ooh, come back, baby, come back. So yeah. That's what we're doing. It looks like he kind of has like a sequined sheet on his head. So I'll probably do that so that way I don't have to do my hair. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get started. Let's bring you guys in so that way you guys can see all of my pores and all of my blending. I know y'all are ready. I know you are.
My channel. Hey. Today I have a very fun tutorial featuring the Naked Urban Decay Naked Heat Palette. Yes, okay. I am not like those other YouTubers that say, guys, I am not naked. No, bitch, I am full titties, naked.
Hold up. What? Do I need to get naked? Do I need to get naked? I can't even take myself seriously. Okay, back to the tutorial. This man is naked, and now I'm naked. We all naked.
Today, and I love this look. This look is a beautiful, warm, smoky eye with a hint of
I love it.
Blue liner and a beautiful orange lip. Of course, bronze skin. And I thought I would just get naked for you guys today and just film this tutorial. Put
naked.
A t-shirt on my
I'm
head
naked.
And call it a day because it's just so much fun. These colors are beautiful. Despite what other haters say about this palette on social media, this is a da bomb. Oh my gosh, look.
Da bomb.
This is the bomb.com. The packaging is beautiful.
All right, we got to skip ahead because we're going to be here forever if we don't.
Let's jump right into the tutorial. Hey guys, so I'm going to take my milk blurring stick. It's like the professional in a deodorant form. I'm just going to apply this all over my face to smooth out them pores, okay?
Okay, so I don't have the milk blurring stick, but I do have this. This is the Milani Instant Touch-Up Blur Stick. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put it all over. Kind of draw it in like he's doing. Okay. This is going to be kind of difficult. I'm going to be like watching and pausing. If you guys hear toys in the background, It's my little dogs. All right, so.
Top Kabuki Brush.
Hold up.
In the shade 450 SUEN Sue Neutral. And I like stippling this on the face. It really gets everything in. This color is literally me.
Okay, hold up. You're going fast. He's going way fast. He didn't even like, you know, smooth it in with his hands. I always feel like no matter if I use like a blurring stick or something, I still need to smooth it in with my hands, if that makes sense. Okay, moving back to the foundation. He said that he was using the Tint Idol Ultra Wear Foundation by Lancome. I have the same one. This one is in the shade 250 Bis W. Ooh. So the flat brush I'm gonna use is this one. This one is by Collab. This is our angled foundation brush. Dang, this is gonna be difficult. Pausing, playing.
I am in the shade 450 SUEN Sue Neutral. And I like stippling this on the face. It really gets everything in. This color is literally. Ooh. So if you want a full coverage, I use a combination of beating the face.
This looks white.
Beating the face. So I'll push foundation into my skin and I'll also distribute it evenly in circular motions.
Hold the phone. I got half my face done. All right, so he said he's pushing the foundation into the skin. Mind you, I got this foundation earlier at Ulta just because, I mean, he used it in the video and I was like, oh, I need that foundation if I'm gonna do this look. And the guy color matched me. And I don't even know if he color matched me correctly because I'm looking hella pale. But I'm hoping it oxidizes. Because boy. At this point in time, I'm really thinking the guy at Ulta color matched me the wrong way. I look like a ghost. Do I not? I look like a ghost. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this off. I'm probably just gonna use a NARS foundation I have in the closet. Like, let's be real. Like, my actual skin color is probably darker than this. All right, we need a redo.
All right, kids, I am back with my brows beat.
Okay.
Painted in my eyes.
All right, now he has brows done and his eyes are primed. So I need to touch up my brows and prime my eyes. So I'm gonna go in with the Benefit Goof Proof Brow Pencil. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do it off camera and then I'm gonna come back because that's what Patrick did. That's what he did. Okay guys, so I'm back. I went ahead and did my brows off camera and I also primed my eyelids and they're definitely creasing like a chicken, okay?
With my brows beat, painted in my eyes, creasing like a chicken.
Like a chicken.
On a Sunday morning at Waffle House. Okay, so I have the Tarte Mary Poacher Concealer and I'm trying to bring this back. This is one of my favorites. It's heavy duty. I've been watching Drag Race. It's
okay, Tarte Mary Poacher Creaseless Concealer. He's highlighting directly underneath his eye, down the bridge of his nose. Is he? Did he? I don't know. Yeah, he did. And his chin and also the center of his forehead. I'm going to take her and put her underneath the eyes like so. Damn, it looks like he was using a lot. Mine's isn't even half as vibrant as his. Let me rewind. So we have it underneath the eyes. We also have it right here. We have it down the bridge and also on his chin. Okay, let's continue.
This on a flat brush and just ooh, that is bright. Next, I'm gonna set.
Oh, he didn't even blend it out. Hold up. Do I blend it out with a brush? I think I'm just gonna use this brush right here by ColourPop. And I'm just gonna go ahead and buff it out underneath the eye. Dude, he literally went from like applying this to like setting it with powder. I'm like, wait, hold up. I feel like this is kind of like a wake up call. Hold on, I need to clean this. I need a beauty sponge, I really do. So to buff and blend this out, I am just gonna use a Real Techniques Miracle Sponge. Not really sure how it's gonna work. I don't know if I love this concealer, to be honest, but Patrick used it, so I'm gonna use it. just gonna keep going. I'm gonna run with it. I have no idea how Patrick blended out his concealer, but I am going to just blend mine out with a little mini miracle sponge right here by Real Techniques. I feel like I put on a lot. This is a pretty thick concealer too. I haven't used it in so long. Just keep blending, blending. Okay. Do I look like PatrickStarrr yet? There we go. Concealer's blended. All right, Patrick. I'm catching up to you. Let's see what else he has going on. It shows that he immediately starts setting with powder, and he looks like he is using a booty blender. So as you can see, setting down with powder. I don't have that Derma E powder that he used, but I do have the Laura Mercier Loose Translucent Setting Powder. So I'm gonna go on with this. So one thing I am noticing about this concealer is that you immediately have to set it down, which is probably why he went so fast. So I'm gonna press her under here. His is like super white though. Like, I don't have a powder that white. I'm sorry. We're getting there. He did a serious bake under there. But maybe you have to with that concealer. Oh no, it's doing something weird. Okay, so I'm baking underneath my eyes. Things are getting messy. I'm baked! My face looks flawless. Super flawless. Oh, I need to do that. Oh shit. Okay, so he used a big puff like this. I only have one from Sephora in my collection. So this guy right here. He looks like he just like put it all over, you know what I mean? So damn it. I feel like I'm gonna waste my Laura powder. This man put it everywhere. Like, trying these PatrickStarrr techniques. What's up? Y'all not ready? I'm not ready. So I'm gonna put this in here, I guess, right? That's how he did it. I don't know, my puff is big. Okay. And he just went, Patrick literally went straight like this. Like, the movement. This man baked his whole face. Is this right?
So now that I have 7 eyes, next we're moving on to eyes. I have the star of the show. This is the Urban Decay Naked.
All right, so he said now that he set his eyes, it's time to move on to eyes. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that same Laura powder, and I am just gonna go in and set my eyelids down. But first I need to, you know, make sure the concealer is nice and blended. Damn. He is moving, Patrick. You are moving.
My Twitter, be sure to apply, but this.
My nose is itchy, so boy.
Beautiful. Oh my goodness. Can we talk about this?
Okay.
This is so gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
I'm going to sauce and logo and apply this in the crease of my eye. These colors are to die for, and I'm going to use a Morphe M504 brush.
In the video, Patrick is taking sauce and also a low blow, and he is taking it on a Morphe brush. I'm just gonna use my Sigma E40 blending brush, but I'm definitely gonna mix the two together, and he's putting this in his crease. So I'm gonna go back and forth. I feel like I'm gonna have to constantly keep going back and rewinding the footage because it does go so fast. I guess I never realized, like, when I edit videos that the cuts are so quick that people may find it hard to follow along. So I feel like this is definitely like a learning experience. I'm just hoping that this powder doesn't look this crazy when I wipe it off. So I kind of feel like his eyeshadow is still like a little bit more intense in mine. So I am trying to build it up, All right, so now.
I'm gonna go ahead and pull the eyeshadow back. If you guys are afraid, don't be afraid to do this. It just makes your eyes look more sexy and more smoky and more cat-like. And you can do this with shadows. So I'm going to take the brush and pull the shadow back towards
the brow,
my temples.
Okay. He's saying take the shadow and he's going to pull it back like this. I feel like I need a different brush or a smaller brush. I'm gonna use this brush. This is a Morphe M441, which is a little bit more pointed. I feel like I'll be able to get better application. So I'm gonna pull her back. I don't know, y'all. I'm like really nervous because, like, you guys know, I normally never do my makeup like this. I never like start with my foundation and powder. I normally just do my eyes first, so that way it's like easy cleanup. But like with this, I feel like I need to be like extra careful. Honestly, I feel like doing your foundation first and then your eyes is only for the pros, and I'm not feeling like a pro right now. I'm really not. just gonna intensify it like a little more right here, and then I think I'm gonna move on because things are looking wild and intense. Help me. Did I go? I think I went a little crazy. Patrick is really challenging me right now. He really is. Challenge accepted.
I'm gonna take a little bit of He Devil and rub this in the crease just to create some hot fire. He Devil is such a nice color. I don't know about the name, but it's a nice color. Bitch, you could stop right here, you'll be good, because I love.
So now Patrick is telling me to take a little bit of He Devil and rock that in my crease. I am just gonna take that on a Sigma E25. And I'm gonna start right here in the crease, and then I'm just gonna follow the outline that we created. So I'm gonna rock it in here, and then I'm gonna take it out a little bit, but I'm not gonna take it out all the way because it looks like he just kind of focused it on the crease area. Whoo, things are looking intense. Super intense.
Next, I'm gonna take a little bit of En Fuego and Ashes. I'm gonna mix these two colors together to get that deep, let's just call this combo Deep Devil, Deep Devil color. I'm gonna run this through the crease ever so slightly. Just shove the brush in the crack of your eye and just go to town.
All right, so now we're mixing En Fuego and Ashes together to get kind of like a deep color, and we're gonna focus it on the very outer portion of the crease. So I'm gonna mix these two, and he said rock it into the crease ever so slightly, ever so slightly. Patrick then went in with this shade right here called Lumber, and he took it wet on a brush. So the brush I'm gonna use is just this cream concealer brush right here. This one is by Sigma. I'm going to take my brush, and I'm actually gonna dab my brush into the product first, and then I'm gonna spray it with Fix Plus, because sometimes I notice when I wet my brush and then rub it in the shadow, it kind of like messes the shadow up, so that's not what I am going for. So I'm gonna take this, and I am just going to press it, and I use Fix Plus, so it's gonna act as a little bit of an adhesive, like Patrick said. Ooh, ooh, so pretty.
Urban Decay gifted all the YouTubers and said you should have content for your channel for the same look you've been doing for the last year. A warm smoky eye. Guilty. Now I'm taking a little bit of Scorched and using this deeper frost on the edge of the lid, right around here. So it's like transitioning into the crease.
So I'm definitely feeling a look, and I will say that I am getting a watery, I'm getting watery eye syndrome, which is where my eyes will water in the very outer corner, which is why I kind of feel like I don't do this and I do my foundation last, so that way I could just kind of clean everything up. I don't know if I'm going to be able to save it based on what's happening right here. It's like separating the powder and the concealer and the foundation. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wipe the bake off. I am. I have to. I really do. So I am gonna take off almost my entire face, the powder, the foundation, everything from the eyes down. So Patrick is using an electric blue liner as opposed to a black one, which is honestly the main reason it drew me to wanting to create this look. He is using something by Makeup Forever. I don't have that product. I just have this by Urban Decay. This is the Razor Sharp Long Wearing Liquid Eyeliner in the shade Chaos. So I will be using this to do my wing liner.
I'm gonna go ahead and take this on my brush.
So he starts from the very inner corner, and then he works his way outwards. I think we got this. I'm not gonna lie, but that literally took me forever, and this is a side that's actually watering really, really, really bad, which is why I had to wipe off a lot more shadow on this side. So what Patrick is doing now is he is applying a little bit of mascara, and he's popping on Miami Lashes by Lily Lashes. So I'm gonna apply some mascara. This is the L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara, and I'm just going to coat my lashes really quick.
So moving on, I'm gonna dust all my baking powder and use the Charlotte Tilbury number 3 Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder.
Unfortunately, I do not have the Charlotte Tilbury powder that he is using, so I'm just gonna use this face powder by Milani. This is the Conceal and Perfect Shine Proof Powder, so that's what she looks like. So I'm gonna take some of this and I'm just gonna dust away that bake while also setting the rest of my face like Patrick did. Moving on.
Tulip brush. Katy Perry loved this brush. I used to clean on her. And this is my personal brush because she just loves that makeup being packed in her face. I do too. If you love a full coverage under eye, I would use tulip brush. But this is the Makeup Forever powder in the color 128. And I'm just going to press this.
Okay, so I don't have that Makeup Forever powder in 128, but I do have a lighter powder that I like to use to set underneath my eyes, and this is kind of like a tulip brush. This one is by ColourPop. I'm going to use the Manic Adar Dual Powder in the shade C2, and I'm going to push this directly underneath the eye. So I'm just going to press this right here to kind of brighten, just like Patrick is doing. So I'm really just pressing this here.
This is a foundation powder. I like it because it has extra coverage. You can see I'm only doing the highlighted area. I'm not touching this under the eyes because I don't want it to be too wrinkly. I'm just gonna go ahead and hit this right here as well. This brush is, she don't fuck up my brush. This is one of my favorite parts to makeup, is just brightening this area. Next, I'm gonna take a little bit of Sun Power by MAC. This is a mineralized skin brush.
For blush, I'm going to use a little bit of this just because it is a little bit more of an orange shade like Patrick used. So this is NARS Luster, and I'm going to pop this on my cheeks. This is a little different. Normally, I feel like I do blush last, so I do like bronzer and all of that, and then I do blush and stuff last, but you know, I'm not opposed to it. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go in underneath the eyes. I want to say that's the next step he's at.
Of cayenne and fuego, and dust this underneath my lash line. Do you guys see how it opens up the eye? Mm-hmm. Looking real cute. Okay, I'm gonna turn on my grinder tonight, okay?
Oh, brr. I saw that Patrick has lower lash mascara on, which he didn't do on camera, so I'm actually gonna pop some on. This is the Voluminous Lash Paradise by L'Oreal. Then we're gonna go in with a little bit of alkaline in the waterline, so like right in here. The next thing Patrick did is he used a little bit of this Stila highlighter. Right here, I have mine in the shade Kitten. He obviously is a little bit darker than I am. So I'm gonna pop this here, like so. And he didn't put on a lot because of his texture, but you guys know I like a little bit more of like a really intense highlight, so. Gonna really just build this up here.
Now, I know this other pencil that came in the Naked Heat collection is an eyeliner. This one is called Torch. It's a beautiful orange. Let me tell you, I used this yesterday as a lip liner, and it is TLF, hashtag to live for. Y'all see how much I overlined from my lip?
Okay, all right. So Patrick went ahead and used this eyeliner pencil and Torch to line his lips. He did overline them quite a bit. I don't know if I have to do that considering I'm following his makeup tutorial, but like, I don't think that's gonna look good on me, so I don't really know. Okay, so, ooh. Lips are fully lined.
It's crazy. Look how my small lip and then my PatrickStarrr lip. It's crazy. Is this not the coolest lip color ever? To top it all off, I'm gonna take a little bit of Fuel from the Naked Heat collection and pop it in the center. And last but not least, a little bit of All Nighter so I can get on grinder. I'm just kidding. And spritz my face. I'm gonna change and I'll be right back.
Okay, so I'm gonna put a little bit of Fuel in the center, just like he did. I don't have All Nighter in front of me, so I am just gonna use a little bit of the MAC Fix Plus in the lavender scent all over to really just set and melt down all of that powder.
All right, you guys, that is it. This is the completed look. What do you guys think? Did you guys think I did okay? Do you think I failed? Let me know in the comments down below. If you guys want me to create anybody else's makeup tutorial, also let me know in the comments. I'll be happy to film more videos like this. Like I said, I did choose Patrick just because we do makeup completely different and he definitely pushed me outside of my comfort zone, but I'm loving the look. I think it's sick. I think it's super duper pretty and, you know, barbecue-esque. So if you're going on a picnic, this may be the look for you. With that, guys, I don't think I have anything else to say except I love you. Thank you guys so much for watching. And until next time, I'll be sure to catch you guys all on the next one. Deuces.